since we are live, you can start. Yes, Mr. Idris, you can start.
Okay, thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Idris Piri, your moderator this afternoon. On behalf of the MasterCross Initiative and Afrikunya TV, I'm happy to welcome you all this session. We are excited that you could join the conversation today. We have a great session prepared for you all. The MasterCross Initiative is truly pleased to bring another insightful, impactful session that you have come to expect since our inception. We sincerely thank all our partners, particularly Afrikunya TV, in enabling us to quality content at your convenience from wherever you are in the world today, which makes it the concept to reveal today. Our guest facilitator today is Comrade AMB Ofadam Chukwunonso Charles Esquire. He is the head of Racial Justice and Decolonization and Human Rights Department in Pan-Global Africanism. Not only that, he is the Secretary General of United States of Africa for Nigerian Section, the Managing Editor, the Law Brigade Publisher, the current Editor-in-Chief of African Law Journal India, Managing Editor of International Journal of Law Management and Humanity India, and Legal Advisor to NAUNA. To mention but a few, this great man is the Ambassador of E-Justice India to the mentioned above. Over this session, we'll have at least 2 hours. We'll be having our presentation followed by a 30-minute question and answers. We'll infuse the session with some music, so please don't rush off. The MasterCross will be recorded, so you can catch the video on Afrikunya's YouTube, Facebook pages before I even hand over to the audience and the facilitator. We'll have a short commercial break and we'll be right back. Thank you.
Hello, can you hear me? I hope they can hear. Okay, yeah. Yeah, my topic today is learning legal drafting and legal writing at international level. My name is Comrade Ambassador Paul Chukwunonso Charles Esquire. Actually, I'm current editor-in-chief of African Law Journal. I'm current managing editor of Law Brigade. And in Law Brigade, we manage over 10 law journals. I'm equally editor, managing editor for about 4 journals, like International Journal of Law and Science, ETC. So hearing what I'm going to share with you guys is legal drafting. Legal drafting is not something someone that can just wake up one day and start lecturing on or start teaching on. No, it requires processes, stages. It's not even every student that might have gone into university and come back and start lecturing legal drafting. No. One of my experiences is that I've done a research, I've done over 50 research on legalities and other departments, because I don't have only law as my degree, I have other degrees. So as you're listening, I hope all of you are listening, like Afrikunya TV, Facebook, YouTube, and Zoom. So herein, I shall go further to discuss the legal writing and the legal drafting in international level. Before I continue, I'll first of all say my caveat. I don't intend my audience to put Manchu of conundrum, neither to put them in portmanteau of indesirability, but to make my lecture unambiguous, affirming or apprehending, and deepening your knowledge. That is my aim and objective. Thank you. Then I'll first of all say the fourth definition of legal drafting according to Institute of Advanced Legal Studies in London and the UK City, Bar Association Law Library, define legal writing as as what involved, or legal writing is what involved the analysis of facts, patterns, and presentation of arguments and documents such as legal memoranda and brief. One form of legal writing involves drafting a balanced analysis of a legal problem or issue. Another form of legal writing is persuasive and advocate in favor of a legal position. And that definition goes on saying that legal writing involves the analysis of fact patterns, presentation of arguments in documents such as legal memoranda and brief. Legal writing includes the legal patterns of writing, long essay, thesis, project, etc. One form of legal writing involves drafting a balanced analysis of a legal problem or issue. In furtherance of this, another form of legal writing is persuasive and advocate in favor of a legal position. This is Wikipedia, 2019. Then, according to Oxford Advanced Learner Dictionary, 8th edition to be precise, people define drafting as a rough. If you go to this Oxford Advanced Learner Dictionary, you will not see anything like legal. You only see the word drafting, which means, according to the Oxford Advanced Learner Dictionary, 8th edition, it means that a rough written version of something that is yet in its final form. Okay, look at our Black's Law Dictionary, 9th edition. It defines legal drafting as a practice, technique, or skill involved in preparing legal documents. The study shows that legal research work has still much been conducted under the doctrinal method. As I go further, I will still define what doctrinal method. But that's when I will go further, when I will still be defining other methodology, because we have or have other things to talk about. In legal drafting is a very vast course. If we start discussing it, it will reach a year. But I shall focus on legal research and long essay for the purpose of this lecture. So, The research works are still much conducted under the doctrinal method. That's according to Wikipedia 2020. Legal research is the process of locating an answer to an unknown legal problem, verifying the law and reading cases. Legal research can also be defined as a process of identifying and retrieving information necessary to support legal decision making. Sometimes, legal research can help determine whether a legal issue is a case of first impression that is unregulated or lack legal precedent. Legal research is generally the process of finding an answer to a legal question or checking for legal precedent that can be cited in a brief or at a trial. As a practicing lawyer, I believe you have to benefit one thing or the other. Especially whatever you are doing is under legal writing. All your presentation in court, as in precedent, litigation, even brief, all those things fall under this legal writing. One of advice I have to give, especially to practicing lawyers, that before they do anything writing or after writing anything, they should make sure they go through it thoroughly. For sometimes your opposing lawyer will still use it against you in the law. And maybe sometimes judges may even query you or abuse you because of the type of write-up it put on. So legal writing is very, very important. It is sine qua non as far as law is concerned. In respect of students, when you do your assignment, some of your assignments, most of the assignment requires it, even your long essay project, when you'll be in your final year, you'll be told to write it. You cannot graduate without legal research, which is in undergraduate program, which is called a long essay, where you will embark on a project that a lot of things will require. We shall be discussing it further. Lawyers and law teachers use phrase in this way all the time: draft a brief or draft a letter, edit your writing ruthlessly, omitting unnecessary words and writing for clarity, purpose, and very important. Careful proofreading is particularly important in legal writing, spelling, punctuation, grammatical errors in a document submitted to the court. Opposing counsel or a client can undermine your credibility as a legal professional. Legal drafting has branches which will be stated herein, but we will not discuss them because of the time. Legal drafting. We have branches of legal drafting. One, we have notices drafting. We have legal acknowledgement drafting. We have adoption drafting. We have affidavit drafting. We have agreement drafting. We have apartment sales drafting. We have apprenticeship drafting. We have arbitration drafting. We have Arbitration Act 1940 drafting. We have Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996 drafting. We have assignment drafting. We have birth drafting. We have bond drafting. We have civil pleading drafting. We have company drafting. We have compromise drafting. We have consumer drafting. We have cooperative society drafting. We have dishonor of check drafting. We have divorce, nullity of marriage, and judicial drafting. We have separation drafting. We have easement drafting. We have employment drafting. We have family drafting. We have family foreign collaboration drafting. We have foreign collaboration and joint drafting. We have gift drafting. We have guarantee drafting. We have guardianship drafting. We have hire purchase drafting. We have injunction drafting. We have insurgency drafting. We have labor drafting. We have lease drafting, license drafting, maintenance drafting, marriage drafting, mental ill person drafting, motor accident claim drafting, negotiable instrument drafting, partition drafting, partnership drafting. After partition drafting, we still have partnership drafting. We have patent drafting. We have powers of attorney drafting. We have public interest litigation drafting. We have receipt drafting. We have ratification drafting. We have release drafting. We have rent drafting. We have rescission drafting. We have resolution drafting. We have revenue drafting. We have sales drafting. We have service case drafting. We have shipping drafting. We have shopping drafting. We have selling agents drafting. We have surrender drafting. We have testamentary matters copy drafting. We have tolls drafting. We have trademarks drafting. We have transport drafting. We have trust drafting. Waste drafting. Cyber law drafting. Hindu marriage act drafting. Brigade drafting. We have matrimonial causes act drafting. We have Eurogate parenting agreement drafting. We have writ drafting. We have mortgage draft. This is drafting we have so far. Herein, we shall base our studies on research, and that research is paper presentation. You know, all this article we submit to the journals. That's what we base our own for now. Then after this, we shall be treating a long essay. A long essay is an essay that tends to be longer than 3 pages or 3,000 words or more than. Of course, the division of a long essay will differ from one classroom to another depending on the age and level of student. Google writing. So essay projects. Writing a legal article to legal research. Legal research shall be used for explanation hearing. Drafting is a vast topic that the aim of using legal research to legal article to make it brief. The requirements for an international law journal/articles are: 1, title, name of the author, affiliation, abstract, general introduction, background of the study, aims and objective, statement of problems, research methodology, research question, definition of terms, literature review, main body, recommendations, conclusion, footnoting, and the referencing slash bibliography. Herein, we shall explain them one after the other. When we talk of title, what do you think that comes to your mind? Title could mean the name of your article, paper, or your research work. Example, legal assessment of bankers and customers' rights in Nigeria. This is an example. Then the name of the author could mean maybe I'm using myself as a case study of all researchers. Then the affiliation is the name of the company or the institution or maybe organization or maybe the legal firm that you're with. Example, your university law firm or working or the place you're working with, maybe your affiliation. That's the affiliation. Then when we talk of abstract is summary of your research work. Example, title, brief introduction of your work, statement of the problem, aims and objectives, findings, recommendations, and conclusion. Then we are in general introduction. If it's in long essay, general introduction is in chapter one, but in legal research, it is not like that. We write it together because there's difference between legal research and long essay. Here, I want to chip in something. For instance, if you talk of the legal research, in that legal research has to be about maybe 5 or 10 legal research that will make a journal. A journal is a combination of many legal research. Like this one, I'm giving an example, but this one we are talking about, which is legal research. All this legal research has to be about 5 or 10 or more than that has to be together to make a journal. So once you hear journal, know that journal is a combination of legal research. And you know, there's a difference between a paper or write-up, or there's a difference between a paper or write-up and legal research. Once it is called a research, whether it is legality or outside the law, it is a research work. It means that you are talking about something that has been researched upon. For example, you may be writing something. Now, let me just use law. Law could be defined as a policy that has been implemented, that has been enacted by act of parliament. As you're saying it, you can just bring a write-up, or a quotation, or another research from maybe African Law Journal or maybe from International Law and Science, and quote one or two things that authors has said about it. That is what makes it a research. It makes the research when you are talking about something, then you have to bring other people's opinions to add to your own. That is what makes it a research work. It's not something that will just come up and just be saying on your own. That is it. So once you are talking about a research work, know that it is not your knowledge only. You can be talking about your knowledge, but you can back up with other people's knowledge. And that is the reason why sometimes as editor I am, there's some work you bring. I will advise you that this work is not researchable. Sometimes in universities, the lecturer could tell you this work is not researchable. What do you think that it means by saying that particular work is not researchable? It means that nobody has written something on it. Once it has not been written on, it is not researchable. Researchable means that people have researched on it, somebody has written something on it so that they can now use it to write on. It doesn't mean plagiarism, no. It means when you are talking something, for instance, as I've given you ab initio or prima facie, that law can be defined as a policy or an act of parliament. You now bring another quotation of another person's quotation. You may see maybe T.O. Omai, you may say so. Or T.O. Omai is one of the editors of African Law Journal. Or use someone and a scholar, or you can even probably use me. I'm one of the scholars as far as legal fraternity is concerned. So that is how we do it. That is what is called legal research. Then maybe when you're writing, when you talk of legal writing, anything, you know, anything that is written in law, fraternity is legal writing. Maybe brief, etc. Provided it is under legal fraternity, it is legal writing. It is not a legal research. Okay, herein I stopped at general introduction. This is the introduction of your work. Background of the study. This is section to detail your background, history, origin, and everything you know about your research work. Note, choosing your research topic is based on what you know or what you like, what is researchable, and what you feel like you can research on. Aims and objectives. This session deals with the purpose of writing your research work and what you want it to achieve. Statement of problems. This session is where you state the problems that made you to embark on the journey of your work. Research methodology. This is method you want to use to embark on your research work. Example, quantitative method, doctrinal method, primary and secondary method, etc. So when you talk of any research work we see that has all this mathematical formula, note that it is quantitative methodology. Once you see all this research work, especially in methodology aspect of it, where it has grammar, because it speaks most of English, but it must back it up with authorities. Perhaps primary and secondary methods, etc. Let's go to research questions. This is a session where we ask questions we will later answer in every research work. Sometimes we take this question to outsiders who our research work is rated in their field to answer before embarking our research. The answers is much, especially when we are using primary methodology. Because nobody is an epitome of knowledge. Once a research is being carried, you have to design something like questionnaire. Sometimes you may not design questionnaire. You may still go out to ask other people their opinion. As you're writing, you might say, Mr. B. Ben said this according to the interview carried out by me, you know? So that is how it is done. Division of terms, this deals with one after the other explanation of some vital words used in your research work for easy understanding, or maybe those difficult words in field that maybe the reader may not understand. Literature review. This section deals with the review of your research work, etc. Talking about your research work with reference to other previous work done in a related work. Note, some works are researchable and some topics are not. What this means is that nobody has written any article on it. You are only allowed to embark on journey of only researchable work in education in general. Personally, I've written over 12 research work in different fields for people. I have researched in education, social science, pure science, agriculture, law, environmental science, etc. I'm a theorist in social science during my postgraduate research work in conflict resolution studies. Name of my theory is psychosocial individuality theory. Another name for it is icon theory. Let's go further. Main body, this deals with the major work of your research work, where you discuss everything like merits, main content. This is where we discuss other things like main content with references. Notes, what makes research work is reference. Without reference, is an ordinary article, not a research work. Recommendations, these sections deals with your recommendations, what you recommended for your readers to learn as a solution to your findings. Conclusion, this section deals with conclusion of all your work at the end of your research work. Footnote, this is footnoting your research work, so referencing your research work on the footnote of every page of your work. It is Microsoft Word that can do this. Take notes. It is only in legal fraternity we use footnoting for now. But legal fraternity is just using that archaic method of research. References or by bibliography. This is where we reference our work at end of the research work. With this, I'm done with the legal research. The next one I shall be treating is long essay. So stay with us. When we talk of long essay, which is under legal research, this is the project that students write when they were in final year to conclude their LLB studies. The legal research and long essay are related, but long essay went further, as you can see in this lecture. Okay, let's start from the cover page. Cover page is where you briefly introduce yourself. Then we talk of title page. Title page is where you introduce yourself, your faculty, and your department. As they are just interrelated. Like when I was giving this lecture on WhatsApp, I gave them some examples, which I'm not with here. Then the next one is dedication. Dedication is like, it's just written like an acknowledgement where you dedicate your work. Maybe most time, my own work, I always say that I dedicate my work to God Almighty. Then when we talk of acknowledgement is when you acknowledge all the people who might have helped you in one way or the other in that very long essay. Then we talk about declaration. That is where you declare that your work is original and it has been written by you. There is no other person who did not copy your work. Another one is certification. If that is where you satisfy your work in long essay. Then we'll talk of abstract. Abstract is summary of your work. Then sometimes some of the supervisors may confuse you because in my experience, some abstracts are not dissenting, especially in some departments. Some will tell you it is this, some will tell you it is the other one. Like there was a time I was embarking on a research work. The particular supervisor was saying that the abstract has to the abstract that the that what is it called research question has to be in abstract. But most important thing, let me advise you this: once you're embarking on any study, whatever you are told to do, please do it. Don't argue with your supervisor. Don't argue with editor in chief. Don't argue with the editor. Whatever you are advised, whatever you are told to do it like that. That is the best advice. But if you ever say or do anything contrary to that, you are finished. So you must try to obey your supervisor or your editor, depending on the type of research work you're carrying on. As I was saying, abstract is a summary of your work. Example, title, brief introduction, statement of the problem, instant objective findings, recommendation, and conclusion. Then the next one is chapter one. In chapter one, we have what is called general introduction, which reduces your work generally. We talk of background of the study, which is where you state history, origin, everything you know about that research work. But it must be background. And it's not something that will contain maybe 3 pages, highest half page. Though there will be a level you'll be, maybe in your PhD, they may tell you to extend it. Aims and objectives. This section deals with the purpose of your writing. Statement of problems. This section is where you state the problems that you that made you embark on the journey of your research. Research methodology. This is method you want to use to embark on your research work. Example, qualitative method, doctrinal method, primary method, etc. Primary and secondary method, etc. Research question. This is a session where we ask questions, we will later answer in every research work. Sometimes we take this question to outsiders who are our research, who our research work is related to in their field to answer before we start backing on our research or research work. The answers is much, especially when we are using primary methodology and some other methodologies. Division of terms. This deals with the one after the other expression of some vital words used in your research work for easy understanding. Sometimes it's a difficult word that you feel like people may not know the meaning. So you try to aid them in order to define them there. Chapter two is the literature review. This session deals with the reviewing of your research work. Example, talking about your research work with reference to other previous work done in that related work. Sometimes some people will tell you that in your literature review that you might have a summary of the literature. Sometimes some people define their own in other ways. But once it is literature review, you have to review your work. No, some works are researchable and some works are not researchable. Main body, this. The next one is chapter three. Chapter three is methodology, generally. That's chapter three, where you explain the type of method you're using. Mostly in legal fraternity, we don't use mathematical method, but I've never used it in legal fraternity. We only try to explain some things and giving some things that will still give the solution to it. Then when we talk of chapter four is presentation of your results. That is where you present all your results. Because in this chapter four is where you present those research questions found in chapter one. For instance, you may say, who killed so-and-so person? Then there is where you get those results. How many people, and all those questions that you might have gathered from your questionnaire, if you're using questionnaire. Then let's enter chapter five. Chapter five talks about conclusion, recommendation, summary, and reference. That is chapter five. Then recommendation, this section deals with your recommendation, what you feel that you recommend for your readers to learn as a solution to your findings. Conclusion, this section deals with conclusion of all your work at the end of your research work. Then summary of your work at end of your, which is in chapter five. Then reference, you have to reference your work. We have the different types of referencing method, but mostly they use law teachers method in Nigeria. We use law teachers method of Nigeria. We still have a more psychological method of American. That is general one some people use, but in law in Nigeria, they use that law teachers method. But outside that, we still have many other methods that people are using. But my advice here is that once you're embarking on this research work, whatever method your supervisor tells you or your university, because method that university use and country use differs from one country to another. Depending on the one you are told to use, please use it. With this, if there is any question, I'm waiting to answer all your questions. Please go on. Thank you.
This is our chance in the audience to participate in questioning the facilitator. If we have any questions, please bring them forward. The facilitator is ready to pick them up. Anyone with a question? Okay, I trust and believe that we have enjoyed and learned a lot from this session. In case there are those who still wanted to ask more questions or they don't have time here, they need to analyze more of what was discussed, you are free to connect to our facilitator on Facebook or LinkedIn. He's ready to clarify more. And for now, I think no one has a question that I signed to say we have all understood what was discussed. We'll go on a short commercial break, and once we're back, we'll be closing this session. Thank you.
Thank you.